Well, hello, Falcon fans. Welcome to another edition of Bowling Green Falcon Hockey Weekly. I'm Ryan Vallon here with head coach Chris Bergeron. Thank you very much for sitting down.
Thanks for having me, Ryan.
So, coach, it's been quite a while. Your team is on the bye week, but before we get to that, I want to recap the weekend that was the last time you guys played, and that was against Michigan Tech here at home. So you guys earned the split. It looked like you guys used up all your offense in the first game, and it didn't carry over into the next game with a 4-0 loss. But overall, what were your feelings about the weekend?
Yeah, I would agree with you. Friday, you know, a bunch of pucks went in the net. With every bounce that could have went our way, I think it did. Saturday, the first period was obviously, in hindsight, was key for us. We had, I believe, 3 power play opportunities. Hit one post for sure, if not a couple. I think we had the chances at 9-5 in our favor, come out down 1-0, and then it gradually got worse as the game went on. Full marks to Michigan Tech. I mean, obviously, they're a proud group, and Friday night was pretty lopsided on the scoreboard anyway. And they came out and wanted to make amends for that. And I thought we were competitive. I thought we were engaged in the game. I just didn't think we were very opportunistic and very good around the other team's net. And like I say, as the game went on, they just kind of took over more and more. We'd been on the good side of, I mean, that was the fifth time we played them. We'd been on the good side of 4 of those, including with the shootout, one of them. And I think that was bound to happen. They had earned it. They deserved it. But I wasn't totally unhappy with the way we played. I just was unhappy with the result.
Moving ahead to what has already happened this past week, your team was on your bye week. Talk a little bit about maybe the positives and negatives of being on your bye week, because it looks like you guys were a little bit dinged up, and that allowed you to get some time to get healthy.
At this time of year, I'm not really sure there's many negatives other than you want to get back playing to make amends for losing 4-0. But I think it was the positives way outweigh the negative, and that is rest. I mean, this group needed a rest. We'd been playing a bunch of hockey since December 28th and kind of the beginning of the second half. And we were dinged up a little bit. One of our guys got the flu, but a bunch of them had some other kind of bug for, you know, 24, 48 hours. So that came at a perfect time. So I just think it's hopefully a recharge for what we want to be a good push here to finish our year.
Looking at the standings, your team is still standing at number 3. One versus three, it seems like it's very, very close. How much of the standings do you guys look at, and how much does that factor into what you guys tell the team?
We don't talk about it much in front of the team, but we know that everyone's looking at it. I mean, as you say, we're in third place. I believe we're 7 points up on Bemidji with the same number of games played. So we're in a good spot. I think we want to solidify third first. You get home ice, now you want to finish as high as you can. That second place is kind of a big deal, because you could potentially host a semifinal round if the home teams win. And last year we had to go on the road for the semifinal round. Now we were lucky enough to get through that round, but we want to be at home as much as possible. And I still think that's in our grasp. Now we're going to need some help, and then obviously the regular season championship, that's might be a little bit of a stretch right now because of how well Minnesota State has played, and Northern's right on their heels too. So it's one of those ones where we want to control what we can, which is ourselves. And if it's meant to be, we'll get some help. And if it's not, then third place is where we'll be. But our focus is Anchorage. Our focus is making sure we play well come this weekend.
And speaking of Anchorage, that is your next opponent. The team leaves, I believe, Tuesday, and then games Thursday and Friday. What are you looking from Anchorage, a team that you've already seen?
Yeah, I'm looking for a group that's playing their last 2 home games of the year, a group that's saying goodbye to some seniors on Friday, which means a hungry, dangerous group. The cliches of they've got nothing to lose, I don't know if I totally believe that. I guess from a standings perspective, maybe that's true. But these are proud kids, and they want to try as hard as they can, and they want to win these games. And we need to take care of our business. We have no room for error in terms of the standings, in terms of wanting to catch teams above us. And where that starts is making sure that we're focused mentally. We do the best we can to get ourselves right physically come Thursday. You're right, we do leave Tuesday, and there's what we think is ample time to be ready come Thursday night. And that's going to be our focus. But I'm expecting Anchorage to be hungry and want to play well this weekend.
All right. Thank you very much, Coach, for sitting down with me.
Thank you.
Of course, I will have both games for you on the Falcon Radio Network live from the Last Frontier in Anchorage, Alaska on Thursday and Friday. And don't forget to follow Bowling Green Falcon Hockey on Twitter and Instagram with the handle at BG Falcon Hockey. We'll see you later.